Hey everybody, Matt Lehman, the owner of SpatulaCityRecords.com and Finders Thrift and Vinyl in La Quinta, California. So today, it happens, whether you want to admit it or not, maybe you're pulling a record off and you hit the deck and you scratch your record, or someone drops something on it, or you got kids, or you got cats or something, and you get a scratch record. That sucks. Can you fix it? Sometimes. Sometimes is the only answer I can give you, because every record's going to be a little different. But I'm going to go through the steps and show you how you can fix most, if not all, not all, but most. So for today, I've got a copy of Sam Cooke's Best Of. It's not an expensive record, but it is a great record, and it deserves the attention if I can fix it. As you can see, there is a pretty gnarly scratch on it. Yeah, you see it almost runs all the way the whole length of the record. It doesn't skip, so that's good, but it's got a gnarly pop on it. And as far as I'm concerned, Sam Cooke deserves better than a pop all the way through his record. So let's cut to, here's what it sounds like without being fixed. Now, before we get into how you fix a record, I'm going to kind of explain what's going on. Most of you probably already figured this out, but it's also nice to see it in live time, because I'm not going to really be able to show you what I'm doing. I'm going to thanks to the prop department for the props that are coming up, so check this out. Okay, so these are the grooves of your record. Okay, your needle comes along and reads the information off of it, moves on to the next one in concentric circles, keeps going. When you scratch, or a record gets scratched, what happens is something comes across it this way and moves these grooves out of alignment, okay? So this right here would probably be a pop or a tick or something like that, because what happens is the needle comes down here, hits this, and when it comes to the edge of that lip, it pops over. This is a better example. Pop right there, and that gives you a pop. And then if it continues on like this, it would be a pop, and then the next one pop, and then the next one pop. So that's where you get your ticks. If for some reason this is all the way jacked over, what happens is your needle tends to follow the next groove, and that's how you get a skip. Okay, and it can be a skip back, and that's when this goes this way, and then it just keeps looping and playing the same thing over and over and over again. If it skips forward, then you miss a beat or whatever it is, and it moves on to the next one. And then it usually will continue to play the record fine, unless you've got a bunch of them. So the way to fix that is you got to line these back up, okay? Once you get these lined up, sometimes you'll get a little bit of a pop and a tick, because it's really tough to smooth these completely out, because remember, most needles not only grade or read on the bottom of the track, but they also read the sides, both sides, on stereo. Not necessarily true on mono. In fact, it's not true on mono, but on stereo, it's reading the sides, so it's coming down and reading both sides, so it's still gonna hear a little bit of noise. Sometimes you can completely fix that, like you'll see on the Sam Cooke, and sometimes you cannot, so that's your prop. So how do you do that? You need to have a very powerful magnifier. This has a light on it. It's got a blue light and a white light. And then you also have to have a needle, a very, very sharp needle. And I just put it on the end of an eraser. And I go through those grooves. You put the magnifying glass on top of the record, and you find out where that scratch is, and you slowly pull them out. Now, you can try it with a wooden toothpick, and people say they like toothpicks because they don't necessarily damage. If you're using a needle, you can really dig into the vinyl unless you're being very, very careful with it. But for me, a wooden toothpick usually isn't narrow enough. So I always try to find the sharpest needle. And I change these needles out quite a bit when I'm working on it. And that's basically it, slow and low. I would highly recommend testing it on a couple other dollar records or records that you don't care about, so you can get a feel for how to do it before you start going into Miles Davis kind of blue and stuff like that. I can tell you off of all of my experience, there are certain records that work really well, and there are certain records that do not work very well at all, and some of them do not work at all. Mostly the mid to late 80s that were really cheap, thin vinyl, not necessarily Dynaflex. Dynaflex, I find, are actually really easy to work with, and they do really well. In fact, I think this Sam Cooke might be a Dynaflex. those heavy metal ones, they put a lot of tracks on there, so their grooves are really, really tight, so you can't really get a needle in there, and you end up just causing more skivs. Heavier records like 50s, 60s, jazz, mono records, those are just easy. That's just easy money for me. If someone brings me in one that's scratched, I can fix that pretty quickly. And you can kind of work out the grooves, especially on those monos. You can smooth them out quite a bit with practice and a couple different tips. But so here's what this sounds like after I fixed it. Pretty cool, huh? So first and foremost, this trick doesn't always work, or this technique doesn't always work. Usually I can get an upgrade on it, meaning if I have a pop if I have a skip, I can usually get it to a pop or a tick. Sometimes I can get it to be completely clean where you hear nothing. If I have a pop or a tick, I can usually get it to some light noise in the background. This Sam Cooke record is amazing. I mean, I'm surprised at how well it came out, which is the only reason I'm doing as much as I am. You can see that the skip goes through almost four tracks. I would not normally do this much work for what would be a $5 record. But I think Sam Cooke is worth it, and it's coming out so beautifully that it's probably worth it. This has and will take me probably close to an hour to do that. So realistically, an hour worth of my time for a $5 record is not worth it. This should be a coaster, but Sam Cooke holds a special spot in my heart, so I'll save his record. I always, when I do this, I'll go back and forth, meaning I'll come in from the one side and then go back and then spin the record 180 degrees and then go through the other side. Because remember, as a needle goes through, it's reading the sides and the base or the bottom. So the cleaner or the better you can get those sidewalls cleaned, the less noise you're gonna have on it. You can see on here, I don't know if, I'll try to do a close up, but if you can see at different angles that it's been doctored. You can see that where the scratch is, there's a lot of work around it. So that's a good trick also, or good information to know if you're looking at a high-end record in a record store and you see that, it means somebody has fixed it. It doesn't necessarily, that's up to you to decide whether you want it or not, or whether you like it or not. So know that if you're looking for a record that's going to look perfect and play perfect, this is going to show some marks, so that's probably not the record for you. But if you're just looking for a record that's going to play good or play cleanly through with maybe a little bit of noise, then this trick may help you out. This trick also works great for, like, if you have a record that is popping in one spot or ticks in one spot and you can't figure out why. There's no scratches, there's nothing in there, there's probably something in the track. So if you can go in with a needle and a magnifying glass and find it, then you're good to go. That's one of the reasons I tend to keep an eye on or a cheaper end turntable in here, so that I can do the scratch technique, meaning I can turn the turntable off. When I know it's coming up, I'll turn the turntable off and then gently slide through that groove until I find where it pops so I can find it. Because it can be real tedious to try to go through these grooves, because at 33 RPMs, you think your eye can catch where it's coming in, but it's not. You're gonna miss probably by 2 inches. So trying to find 2 inches by 2 inches all the way around a record is a nightmare. It'll take you forever just to find it. So I tend to keep a smaller or a cheaper turntable, one that I can scratch with or at least guide through the track. So that's it. I highly recommend testing this out first. Track again, practicing on a couple records that you don't care a whole lot about, or if you have a record you can scratch it yourself and then go in and try to repair it and see how it works. Practice is going to be key. Do not start this with a $100 record or beyond. And it takes a while. It takes time to figure out, and your technique's going to be probably a little different than mine, but that's a good start, and I hope this works for you. I hope you can save some records. That's what it's all about. Remember, SpatulaCityRecords.com. All records are ultrasonically cleaned before they go out. There are buy nine, get one free, or buy nine and get one for a penny. And all orders over $50 or more in the United States are shipped for free. Please follow us on Instagram, like us. We also have a YouTube channel. Everything's under Spatula City Records, spatulacityrecords.com. And if you're local, Finders Thrift and Vinyl La Quinta. If you're local and you're afraid to do this to one of your records, you can bring it to me. I'll take a look at it and see where I can go from there. Thanks again for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Later.